continue to work and go through the wreckage to figure out exactly what caused this deadly crash. Now, our Sam Carter, he's live for us this morning with the latest on that investigation. Sam.
Yeah, here at Grade Lane, where the road is still shut to everybody but officials, NTSB, and some waste management employees. But it's those officials we've seen come and go all day from NTSB. Since about 5 o'clock this morning, emergency response vehicles have come to and from because this is a key time for that NTSB investigation. Now, key discoveries were made during day one yesterday. As Carrie said, that black box was recovered, and NTSB will be combing through video of the crash. They'll be combing through maintenance records, all to get an understanding of what happened. Now, this investigation is being led by Todd Inman, who told us that this may help future events like this never occur.
We don't know until it gets to Washington, D.C. I will tell you that they're manufactured to a very specific standard. Luckily, they were not in a post-impact fire for multiple days or on the bottom of the ocean. So while the fire may have been intense, it is built to withstand that. And once we get them to D.C. and we can open them up and take the steps, and sometimes we have to take multiple steps, now it will be multiple or at least several days before we have a readout of those.
Now, Inman there was speaking about the black box, giving details about what the process is to pull that key information that will be vital to finding out what actually happened to this cargo plane. We'll have more in the next half hour. Until then, Sam Carter, WLKY News.
Yes, Sam, a large debris field and a lot of debris for them to comb through, which is going to take a while. Now, back here.